Now, let's take a look at the structure of the template. First, let me explain the scene view and game view located in the center. The scene view is basically an editable screen where you can place and remove objects. In the scene view, you can move the camera by combining the mouse and keyboard. Typically, you move forward, backward, left, and right with the arrow keys, and adjust the camera direction by holding the right mouse button while moving the mouse. You can zoom in and out of the scene view using the mouse scroll. The Build It Asset Browser and ZEPETO Scene Settings tab are UIs that are unique to the Build It template. Let's drag and drop the Asset Browser on the right side of the hierarchy, and the ZEPETO Scene Settings on the right side of the inspector. You can search for and select objects from the Build It Asset Browser and place them on the map. The categories on the left represent object themes. There are over 19 themes, such as cafe, cherry, city, and more. There are also effects available to decorate your map nicely. The utility category contains objects with special functions. We'll cover these in detail in the next chapter. The hierarchy tab displays the list of objects placed in the map, similar to a file explorer in Build It. On the right, you'll see the inspector, which shows the properties of the selected object. Just like in Build It, you can edit the object's properties. Next, let's look at the game view, which is in the center again. The game view is a preview or runtime view. When you press the play button, the view automatically switches to the game view. You can change the resolution of the game view to make testing easier. The project window at the bottom is where you organize and manage all the files within the template. Think of it like your computer's file explorer. You can create folders, add files, rename, or delete them. You can find resources here and apply them to the scene. You can also adjust the size of each layout with the mouse, so feel free to change it to suit your workflow. Now, let's learn the features to start creating your map. Select a category from the Build It Asset Browser on the left. Let's choose City. Select an object, then click on the ground to place it. You can keep placing objects as long as you continue clicking. If you want to deselect the object, right-click or press the Escape key. After that, clicking on the ground won't place any more objects. If you want to delete an object, press Delete on Windows or Command Delete on Mac. When you select a placed object, the gizmo tool for editing objects will appear. You can move the object by grabbing the arrows on the gizmo. The red arrow is the x-axis, the green is the y-axis, and the blue is the z-axis. If you want to move along two axes simultaneously, select a square where the axes intersect and drag. On the left of the scene view, you'll see the toolbar. You can use this to rotate or resize objects. To rotate an object, select the Rotate tool, then use the mouse to move it. If you want to apply an exact rotation, you can enter the values in the inspector on the right. To resize an object, select the Scale tool and drag to adjust its size. If you want to resize it uniformly, you can enter values in the inspector. For example, entering 2 will double the size. Now you've learned how to place, delete, move, rotate, and resize objects. Let's change the sky color. Select the ZEPETO Scene Settings tab on the right of the Unity Editor. You can choose any color you like to make the sky more vibrant. You can also set the ambient color to give a specific color to the entire map. By adjusting the light intensity, you can control the brightness. If you set the ambient color to black and the brightness to 0, you can create a dark map. If you want to reset to the original settings, just click the reset button. Do you remember how we adjust the character's movement speed and jump height in Build It? With the Build It template, there are even more options. Select Manager from Hierarchy. You can set the walking speed, running speed, jump power, and even enable double jump. You can also adjust the height at which the character respawns after falling. Even the ground, which forms the floor of your world, is just a large 3D object. It's implemented by scaling a cube-shaped object and applying a surface called a material on top. In the project, Template Resources, Material Folder, you'll find materials that can represent various natural environments. When you select the ground, you'll see two materials applied in the inspector on the right. The first one is for the underside of the ground. It may not be visible from the character's perspective, but it could appear in map screenshots. You can change this by dragging a different material into it. The second one is for the top surface of the ground. You can change this material as well to create different environments like roads, cookies, flower fields, deserts, and more. You can even set it with an image of your choice. Right-click in the project window and choose Create, then Material. Let's name it Image Material. Next, prepare an image without copyright. You can use an AI-generated image or a photo you created yourself. I'll use a ZEPETO image for this example. Drag the image from your computer's File Explorer into the Assets folder in the project window. Now the image is applied. Select the image material we created earlier. To make sure nothing else gets selected, lock it with the lock icon on the right. You'll see a small square next to the albedo property. Drag the image into that square. Don't forget to unlock the inspector afterward. Now, you've created your own material. You can apply this material to the ground or any object by dragging it onto them. Using this method, you can easily create your own billboards, banners, or signs. Unity has an asset store, which provides 2D and 3D resources, backgrounds, sound effects, and background music that you can use in Unity. Click Window, Asset Store at the top of Unity. Then, click the Search Online button. This will open the Asset Store website. Try typing BGM into the search bar. You'll see both paid and free assets in the results. If you want to use free assets, check the Free Assets filter on the right. After previewing the background music, add the one you like to My Assets. Then, select Open in Unity, which will bring you back to the Unity window. In the Package Manager, download and add the background music you selected. You'll see that a folder has been created in the project window. From the Utility category, drag the BGM object onto the map. Since this is an invisible object, it doesn't matter where you place it. Drag your chosen background music to the audio clip field. Click the play button at the top to make sure the background music plays properly. You can also get free 3D assets from the Asset Store. After adding an asset you like to My Assets, return to Unity and download it. You'll see that a folder has been created in the project window. Just drag the asset you want from the folder and place it in your map. If you've created a 3D object using Maya or Blender, you can easily import it into Unity. Let's use Blender as an example. Save the Blender file you want to add to your world as an FBX file. In Unity's project window, drag and drop the Blender file into the Assets folder, just like we did with the image earlier. And there you have it! Your 3D object is now in Unity. Unity automatically reads Blender files and converts them into usable 3D models. Now, just drag the asset into the map to place it. With the Build It template, you can unleash your creativity even more freely.